Time for a new video.
We all know that starting a Twitch channel or starting live streaming on Twitch can be extremely, extremely confusing. There's so much to learn, grasp, get used to from the very, very get-go and from day one. I know myself that at the start I felt so lost before I figured out a lot of this stuff myself or somebody told me about it. So today I'm gonna tell you guys some things that I wish I knew before I started streaming on Twitch. But before we get into today's video, everybody, I wanna ask you a question. Are you tired of being a dum-dum? Me too. Thanks to Skillshare, none of us have to be dum-dums anymore. Today's video is sponsored by the wonderful, lovely people over at Skillshare. Skillshare is your all-in-one online learning platform with courses on literally everything. If you want to learn video editing, graphic design, gardening, knitting, how to play an instrument, you name it, there is a course available for it on Skillshare. Skillshare provides some highly produced, high-end courses by some of your favorite creators and individuals out there. Some of the best people in the biz, if I'm being frank. One of the courses that recently caught my eye that I thought was just absolutely awesome was Productivity for Creatives. Build a system that brings out your best by Thomas Frank. Thomas is a YouTuber, author, entrepreneur. In this course, he goes through all the things that you really should know if you're trying to build a business as a creative or content creator. He goes through things like cultivating a professional mindset, even at the very start of your journey, how to set up your physical space, your digital space to maximize your creative output. It's awesome. The courses are super accessible. They're super easy to watch and learn from and take notes and stuff in the background. And the first 1,000 people to use this link will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. Huge thanks to Skillshare again for sponsoring today's video. Love you. You're great. Thank you very much. All right. Let's talk about some things I wish I knew before I was an idiot on the internet for a whole year. All right, so it's very likely that when you start out on Twitch, you know, your first few streams, you're gonna be texting your friends and texting your family and all these people, sending them your Twitch link and just asking them to keep your stream open. I did this to all of my friends who may see this video. I'm sorry. Every day before I went live, I just was texting people my link being like, hey man, like, I know we haven't talked in like 7 years, but you know, could you please watch my Twitch stream today? There's nothing inherently wrong with this. You're not damaging your own channel. Obviously it's better to get organic views. I know that, but look, it's very hard on Twitch to get just your first couple of viewers in. And it's a kind of a bit of a confidence booster when you first start out, because you know that at least someone is watching you. I totally understand if you do this. If I was starting a brand new channel, would I have done this? Probably not. You should absolutely be sending your friends your stream, but like, sending people your stream that you know aren't interested in what you're doing just so they can keep it open till you have a viewer, maybe not the best idea. One thing I wish I knew about this was that if you tell someone to mute the Twitch player, it actually does not count as a view. So if you send someone the link to your stream and they're watching it, but they have the actual player muted on Twitch, they're not counted as a viewer. However, if they do mute the tab, they are. I would say avoid doing this if you can. Like, it's better to get those few like actual viewers in there and you'll feel so great about yourself when the first few names pop up in your chat. But if you want to help get yourself started out, get your friends to watch you, it's no problem. But remember, if they mute the player, they don't count as a viewer. One thing I wish I knew was that stream highlight videos get you nowhere. I wasted so much time and money making stream highlight videos. There was days where I didn't have time to edit myself. I paid some of my friends to edit for me. I feel like this is a huge misconception or a huge misunderstanding within the space. People know now that you have to create content other than Twitch, right? Whether that's TikTok, YouTube, or whatever. And you hear YouTube thrown around a lot, but what streamers hear there is, oh yeah, I just cut all my funny clips into a video and upload it on YouTube and get hundreds of thousands of views. Unfortunately not. Ask yourself this, if you're scrolling through YouTube, would you watch a highlight video from a streamer you've never heard of? Probably not. Now, what people are talking about when they say like making discoverable content on YouTube is they mean like if CoolStreamer42 was playing Minecraft Hardcore and they decided to make a series of videos detailing the crazy things they were doing in Minecraft Hardcore, made a very clickable title, made a banging thumbnail, and then used that video to link away to the live version of what they're doing on stream, that's what they're talking about. But simply cutting together all your best clips from the week or all your best clips from the month and just throwing them out on YouTube, it's not really discoverable content. No one will watch stream highlight videos from someone they don't know. There's no harm creating that content if you have the time. It's a great thing for your community who are part of those streams to look back on them in like edited style and cut up and all polished and nice. That's fun for them. So, you know, hey, if you have the time to create them, absolutely do. But don't create them in the hope that, all right, I'm gonna convert these views to followers on Twitch. It doesn't really happen that way. If you're gonna be creating content for YouTube, it has to be clickable, discoverable, searchable. You know, what I'm saying is don't waste a lot of time doing this. Let's say you waste 7 hours editing together a really crazy stream highlight video. That 7 hours could have been spent making TikToks, which are way more likely to be watched. You would watch a TikTok of a streamer you never heard from because it's only asking for like 30 seconds of your time, whereas a 10-minute stream highlight video is a lot to ask of someone who's never heard of you before. So think about where you should be allocating your time. Try not to get overly excited about Twitch. Now, maybe this is just me. I was very guilty of this at the start. I got super excited about anything I wanted to do. So if I had a cool idea for a stream, look, I'm still guilty of this today a little bit, but if I have a really cool idea for a stream, I would just want to do it then and there, knowing that like if I just spend a couple of more days prepping for this, it would be a lot bigger for me. I'll just want to go and get it done. I'm very like that. I'm a very like go and do person. I don't wait and plan. I have to force myself to do that. But when I first started streaming, you know, my computer was barely capable to stream in 720p. Now, I mean barely. I had saved up some money for a new graphics card and a new microphone. This microphone, my first ever streaming microphone, the HyperX Quadcast. This thing is a workhorse. Maybe I'll do a video on this. This is awesome. Point being is that I knew that my stream was bad, and I knew that I was getting a new setup in like 2 to 3 weeks time. Did I wait to stream? No, I just jumped straight in and started streaming in like 480p, crap mic, crap everything. The stream was like 10 frames a second. And that 2 weeks that I streamed on that channel, yeah, maybe I learned a valuable lesson. Maybe I got like more confidence from it, but I also probably ostracized a lot of people who came by my stream who could have potentially followed me had they seen me 2 to 3 weeks later. So what I'm saying is, if you know you're trying to plan something, don't just jump the gun and just do it straight away anyway. Wait till it's good. Don't do it when it's fine. Wait till it's good and you will see the rewards from that. That's something I've really had to teach myself lately. I'm still working on it, but I'm starting to see that when I have ideas and I could probably execute that idea the day I have it, sometimes I stop myself and go, hang on a sec, if I just wait like 3 or 4 days and I can add this thing and add that thing, and it's always better when I wait. It's never that great when I just do the thing or do the idea from the very moment I conceptualize it. But when you wait and give yourself time, your ideas can kind of turn into something way better. This one is a bit cringe, but these are things I did and I'm going to be honest about it. No one cares how fast you are growing, especially not companies. Within the first month I started streaming, I noticed that there was one stage where I was gaining about 100 followers a week. Like, that's pretty insane. In my own head, I was like, I'm growing so fast. No, I don't have 100,000 followers yet, but you know, by the rate this is going, I'll have them soon. So what did Dan do? In his infinite wisdom, Dan started emailing companies looking for sponsorship. And what was my opening line? I'm gaining 100 followers a week on Twitch. No one cared. I had 500 followers at the time. No one cared. Now, look, follower count does not matter at all, right? I've said this before, that there's people out there who have triple my follower count and half my viewership. There's people out there who have half my follower count and 3 times the amount of viewers I have. It really doesn't matter. It's not a great way to sell yourself to a company if you're basically nobody yet, you really don't have the viewership, but you might have a couple hundred followers and try to sell yourself. It was Corsair. I tried to sell myself to Corsair. If anyone from Corsair is watching this video for whatever reason, I'm sorry, can we please talk again? But I emailed like big companies and was like, hey, I'm a new streamer and I'm growing this quickly and I'm doing all these things and I plan to have this and I'm getting a new mic and just all these like cringe things that like any social media manager or any brand manager or whoever looks at those emails would have looked at and been like, buddy, there's 1,000 other emails here just like you and everyone's 100 times bigger. Point I'm making is here is no one cares how fast you're growing. You are only worth what you are worth at that moment in time. You can't sell yourself on the idea that in X amount of weeks or months, I'm going to have this or I'm going to be that. It doesn't matter. Those cool sponsorship things and companies and all that kind of good stuff, that will all come in time. If you're on a cool trajectory, keep it up. Keep doing what you're doing. It's probably working for you. But don't jump the gun and try and get things that you feel are owed to you or feel should be owed to you before they're actually owed to you. No one deserves anything online. It just happens. Celebrate your wins when you have them, not because you think you're gonna get them. And you could potentially stain your relationship with that person if you send a particularly arrogant email. You know, you might stay in your relationship with them down the line. Wait till you have what you are saying you're going to have before reaching out to people. You cannot buy success. I mentioned before on this channel that I joined a stream team very early on into my streaming venture. This stream team was run by a pretty big creator, and he gave anyone who subbed to him at tier 2 or tier 3 access to his stream team with the promise that, you know, he raids people from the stream team every day after the stream. In my young impressionable streamer mind, I'm going, oh my God, all I have to do is pay 10 euros to this guy a month and I'll get raided by like 1,000 people people at one point. Now, little to my knowledge, there was probably like a couple of hundred people in that stream team at the time. And, you know, the likelihood of it ever happening to me was pretty low. I actually never witnessed those raids ever happen, even when I would watch the stream as a viewer. After a while, I started to realize that it was a bit of a scummy thing to do. You're basically throwing money into someone else's pocket with the promise of something in return that is very unlikely to happen. Now, I understand that, you know, it could be argued that all Twitch subs are like that, but, you know, what the point I'm making is that there's no shortcuts at the start, okay? Every streamer at the start, if you're watching this video, you're probably looking for a shortcut, but there is, unfortunately, no shortcuts at the start of Twitch. You can't buy into a raid. You can't buy into any sort of promo. Anyone who's telling you that they're gonna feature you on a website or feature you here or there at the very start is most likely twisting your arm a little bit and being a bit facetious. And that's one thing that I had to learn the hard way after hours or days spent looking for these shortcuts. Dan, there is no shortcuts. You are you, you're doing what you're doing, and it will either work for you or it won't work for you. It's all down to how hard you want to work. Oh my God, I'm sweating. It's like 26 degrees in Ireland and I'm drinking a hot coffee. We're not built for this. Irish people are not built for this. People have said this before, a lot of other creators have talked about this, and I've talked about this as well. Being live for hours and hours and hours does not give you any advantage of growing faster. This was my stream schedule when I first started streaming for like 2 or 3 months straight. Wake up Monday to Friday, 9 a.m. I would stream from 9 a.m. till 1 p.m. I would then take an hour break from lunch and stream from 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. Now, I had just been fired from a job at the time, so maybe I was hunting for a little bit of normalcy. But either way, that did nothing other than just make me so unbelievably tired. It wasn't funny. For the first few weeks, it was fine because I was super excited to be on Twitch and I was super excited to be a streamer. But after a while, you just burn yourself out completely, just wiped. Come Friday night when your friends or whoever want to hang out with you and you're like, I've just streamed for like 50 hours this week and I can't stand. I'm going to bed. It's 8 p.m. That was a bad idea. And I wish I knew that at the start. I would have saved myself so much time and effort. Work smart, not hard. I didn't say it. It's been said 1,000 times. Work smart, not hard. A little effort goes a long way. When I first started streaming, all I wanted was the quick fix follower alerts, the quick fix designs, the starting soon screens, the panels. I was getting them the cheapest I could and the fastest I could from anywhere, free ones, whatever. Now, there's nothing inherently wrong with that. What I started to notice is when I started to put a little bit more effort into those things, I started hearing them and seeing them a lot more. A lot of Twitch or a lot of content creation is luring people in with the illusion that you're a little bit bigger or more important than you are. So for example, a lot of the time when you go on a new streamer's Twitch channel, you expect to see a lot of the same things. You expect to see the kind of mascot esports logo, which I had. You expect to see kind of very basic alerts, all that kind of thing. But if you can put a little bit more effort in from the get-go, you're doing one thing which is separating yourself from everyone else from the very, very, very get-go. Now, I'm not saying that you have to go out and hire a designer and spend thousands of dollars or euros on crazy animated alerts and transitions and stuff. No, it's all stuff you can build on over time, but be wary of that when you're starting, that, you know, a little bit of effort in these things to maybe even just take what everyone else is doing, flip it a little bit, not all the way, but just a little bit, can actually really be to your benefit at the time. I know, for example, at the very start, when I threw in all these kind of pre-made free graphics that I saw online, yeah, they were cool, people liked them, but there was nothing really too dissimilar from what people were seeing on my stream to other people's stream. But when I went on and kind of tried to elevate my brand a little bit and change some things up and add more effort into my alerts and text boxes and panels and all that kind of thing, I did see the stream go up as a result of that. As I've said before, there's a bit of a quality floor now on Twitch that people expect to see a certain level of quality, be it in your graphics or even on the stream itself. It is becoming that where you're kind of expected to have certain things and people appreciate when you do have it. So think about putting a little bit more effort in on those type of things from the very get-go. Establish a good and trusted mod team early on. Now, all of you, in the last few videos, I've mentioned mods so many times, but seriously, day after day, I'm reminded how important mods are. A lot of people don't really think they need them at the start because they're like, oh, I'm small, like nothing's gonna happen. But anything can happen on your stream. You're responsible for the safety of your stream early. I myself had some really bad things happen early on in my Twitch stream that could have been avoided had I had mods and people who knew how to use mod tools and all that kind of thing. It's super beneficial. If you don't need them now, you're gonna need them one day. A group of people who are like-minded, think the same as you, that can help keep your community safe. They have such an important job. Shout out to all the mods out there, especially my own. You're all amazing. You do great work. I didn't do that for a very long time. I just had random people as my mods who just were either never there or didn't know what they were doing. And then once I actually spent time and got people in who knew what was what, my stream was so much better as a result. One thing I wish I knew is that you're going to have to sacrifice a lot if you really plan on making this work seriously. For example, this is kind of how my day looks. Right now, most people, if you have a full-time job, you go to work at 9 and you finish at 5 and you go home. Most of the time. I understand that every situation is different, but a lot of the time that's the case, right? 9 to 5. Whereas for a streamer or for a content creator, I know you might think that this is overkill, but this is the reality of the situation. You're working all day, be it writing these YouTube videos, coming up with these ideas, filming these YouTube videos, editing these YouTube videos. In the evenings on Mondays, I stream. Same thing on Tuesday. Recording, writing, emailing, talking to people, planning, researching. Stream Tuesday evening till 9-10 p.m. Same on Thursday, same on Friday. I offer service on Patreon where I give stream advice to people and they have a direct line of communication to me and they can talk to me anytime. And I love doing it. Shout out to all my patrons, by the way. You're all absolutely awesome. Basically, what I'm saying is you have a lot on all the time. You're never really fully switched off. Even the days that you do take off, I find myself looking at YouTube comments or looking at views or looking at my Twitch or like reading up on a game. You know, you're never really off. One of the things that I thought about this at the very start was that I would just be playing video games and having fun all the time. Unfortunately, that's not the case. Now, don't get me wrong. Would I trade it for anything? Absolutely not. I love doing this more than ever. But be prepared that you will have to sacrifice, you know, some social events, stuff in your personal life, a couple of nights sleep here and there. You got to make that decision whether or not you think it's actually worth it in the end. But everybody, that's going to about do it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I appreciate it. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like on it. Subscribe if you thought it was awesome as well. Coming up on 6,500 subs, so that would be awesome to hit soon. But most importantly, help me appease the algorithm gods by leaving a big thumbs up on the video if you enjoyed it. You can also catch me on Twitch 4 days a week at twitch.tv/x2shoes. And I also stream here on YouTube on Mondays at 7 p.m. GMT. You guys ask questions, I answer them. Sometimes we do setup reviews or streamer reviews over there as well. It's a lot of fun. Check that out on Mondays. Also, other links to things down below if you want to help support me in other ways. There's links to things like Patreon and stuff down there. As I said earlier in the video, I offer like one-on-one streamer advice. We have a Discord channel where we have all the patrons. We can all help each other with our stream-related stuff. It's a lot of fun. So do check that out if that's your thing. If not, that's fine. Don't worry about it. Okay. But that's going to do it for me today, everyone. Enjoy your weeks on your streams. Have amazing times. I hope you make awesome content. If you don't this week, don't worry. Next week's a new one. Back next Tuesday with a new video. Can't wait to see you. Yeah. But yeah, thanks, everyone. Bye. Video's over now. See ya.